I just want to follow up on something that you said earlier in your testimony, or at the end of your testimony. You said that your constituency is the most underrepresented of them all, taxpayers, and you do the grassroots and labor, and then you trailed off. I just want to be clear, you do represent Americans for Prosperity, do you not?
Yes.
So Americans...
Pennsylvania, Americans for Prosperity, Pennsylvania.
And yeah. Americans for Prosperity at the national level was founded by David and Charles Koch, was it not?
They are founding members, yes.
And your organization has fought back on cap and trade. You fought collective bargaining rights. In fact, I was at a hearing for another committee at the beginning of the session where you were fighting back against organizing rights for public sector unions. So I find it questionable to have you say that you represent the taxpayers, the grassroots, and labor today, given the fact that you're from Americans for Prosperity.
I think she actually was referring to that we had one of our testifiers that was here representing labor, and she's here representing taxpayers.
But that's not actually what she said, Mr. Chairman.
Yeah, that's what I heard her say. Maybe it's not what you heard, but I think it's what she meant. Isn't that correct? You were here representing taxpayers. The labor unions you were referencing was our labor union representative.
Yes. I was just representing prior speakers today.
So the taxpayers in my district hold very different positions than the Koch organization. I just want to correct the record for who you're speaking for today. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. It's clear that coal generation is on the decline here in Pennsylvania, even without Reggie. Generation is one-third of what it was when the president took office 4 years ago. No new plants are under construction, and the few remaining plants are rapidly approaching retirement. Now, my colleagues who represent coal country will often talk about the impact of the loss of good-paying union jobs. So what is your industry doing right now to assist impacted communities and workers in the face of a declining industry?
Well, my association solely focuses on coal electricity. So what we're trying to do, which obviously will indirectly benefit communities for workers of the coal supply chain, is to ensure that we do not have any premature coal retirements. Because when you prematurely retire a coal plant, it's the people in the communities who lose the jobs, and it's the people who pay higher electricity prices, and they're going to pay the stranded cost for that investment. And so to replace those, whether that's with natural gas or whether that's with renewables, is going to result in higher electricity prices, because if you look at the levelized cost of electricity right now of a coal plant, which is looking at the all-in costs, and you compare that to building new renewables, solar, wind, even building a new natural gas plant, on a national average basis, it is still a better investment to retain that coal plant, just like whether you're deciding to buy a new car or keep the one that you have because it's already paid off or it's already depreciated and the only cost you have is your fuel, your gasoline. That's the same thing with a coal plant. And so what we're focused on is programs that will increase the efficiency of coal plants that still have a lot of years of life of value to provide all of those attributes that when we turn the light on, we all still want. That intermittent resources by themselves or natural gas by themselves cannot provide with the current technology that is out there today.
So you didn't directly answer my question. I understand that you represent a trade association, but your members are companies who have been extremely profitable. What are they doing right now to help their employees who have driven their profit margin in the midst of this energy transition?
Well, the members that I have certainly invest in all of the communities that they're a part of. One of the reasons that CONSOL is investing in one of the most advanced coal technology projects is because it's going to benefit them and allow them to either keep workers that they have or hire new workers. All of the taxes that this industry pays right now benefits all of the communities and rural areas in Pennsylvania. That's what we're advocating does not go away.
Last question, do you have any idea how much in taxes your members paid in Pennsylvania last year?
Taxes? No, but we could follow up with you on that.